Well, welcome back. And if you tuned in late today, my special guest is Dr. J. Brodie Bricker, who is right now the principal of the Greenville Tech Charter High School. And we're not just plugging Greenville Tech Charter High School, although it is outstanding, but the things that he talks about, they go for every child in every school. The things that you bring common sense to the plate. Yeah. And we've got to step up and make our children understand, and our parents, you know, how important in the future an education is for our children.
Yeah, well, it is important, and culture has changed. And as I said, the schools of yesterday are not the schools of the day for a lot of reasons. Education has to be a number one priority. And public schools don't get to pick and choose who comes through their doors. You know, if you work for a company, you can throw out the defective raw materials. We don't have that opportunity. We have to take children that come in where they are and take them as far as we can take them. Now, the Greenville Tech Charter School is a public school, but it's a little different in the fact that parents know when they come to that school what the expectations are. And the difference is we can allow them to take college classes. It's not a put down of the other public schools. Greenville Tech and the principals across Greenville County, I mean, they're doing a good job every day, trying to do a good job in the classroom. And it's hard. It's hard in our school, too. But you have to let the students know what the expectations are. And one of the sayings in my book I learned on the farm, my granddaddy taught me that the horse don't drive the wagon. We are in charge. Now, children don't know what they want to be when they grow up. And a lot of parents, we have rules. We have a dress code. We have a uniform dress code.
Yes, they do wear uniforms.
They do. And now, a uniform in the standpoint that it's a khaki pants, shirt, shorts, and they wear a navy blue polo type shirt.
Can be bought at Walmart. It's not a fancy.
No. And I did that in a middle school here in Greenville not too long ago in a school that was 76% free and reduced lunch. So it's not about the money, because you can put them in a uniform cheaper than you can put them in saggy pants and football jersey. So it's everybody, it puts everybody on the
and everybody plane. And they're neat.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. And you know, you have to have respect. And in Greenville Tech, I mean, we have what we call the non-negotiables. I had it when I was in the public schools.
Okay, just a moment. Non-negotiables, and you can tell us what that is. But does that hold true for all charter schools or just for yours?
This is ours.
Okay.
I mean, everybody's.
You don't speak for all the charter schools.
No. I just speak for Greenville Tech Charter. And my philosophy is very simple, that we provide a school where teachers can teach and students can learn. But I had that same philosophy when I was at Beck Academy, when I was at Eastside High School. I mean, we have to provide an environment where teachers can teach and students can learn. I don't care where you are. And that works wherever you are.
Now, you don't put up with bad behavior and that kind of stuff.
Well,
they're out the door, and they know it.
Our children are children, and they know what the expectations are. And we deal with that. Now, we don't have a lot of discipline problems. You know, the biggest problem we face in most public schools now is social media, because they can go places that we can never go, and you didn't want them to go, and they can do things on social media that couldn't be done five years ago.
Can be dangerous.
Yeah. So that's one of the things we deal with. And they can have a phone on campus, but they can't use it except at lunchtime. That's their time for 30 minutes. We let them do that. But other than that, if we see a phone, we'll take it.
And they bring their lunch.
They bring their lunch. In our case, we have what we call the Charter Cafe, and each day is a different day. This is where the parents support that, too. Like, Monday might be Papa John's, Tuesday might be Chick-fil-A's,
okay.
Wednesday might be Arby's.
So they come in.
They bring in the food, and the kids know what the day is, and they know they can buy it or bring it. And it works well. We give them 30 minutes for lunch. You're either in lunch or you're in advisory. Every child spends 30 minutes a day with a teacher, 10 or 15 students in an advisory. We have a curriculum. Ninth grade, they may be talking about how to study. They may be talking about behavior. They may be talking about expectations. And when you get to, and all of our students, each grade level has to do community service. The ninth grade does community service for the school, charter. 10th grade does it for Greenville Tech. The 11th and 12th grade do a community service project out in the community. So community service is really big at a charter school. You have to do that. And because that gives back to the community, it also makes people appreciate and understand that we want you when you grow up to be a giver, not just a taker, and also to give back to your community. And our kids really do a good job with that. It helps them see that there are people a lot less fortunate than they are. It helps them see they're helping a community or an agency, or it could even be senior citizens in some project. You know, they pick it out, they do it, they complete it, and they get the satisfaction from it.
Now, they graduate many times with credits beyond what they would ordinarily have.
Starting the sophomore year, if they qualify, they can take two college credits this year. Next year, the college is going to change that, and they can take more. But it's not unusual out of our senior class of about 100, okay, for half of them or more to graduate with 24 college credits or more. Had one young lady last year that got two associate degrees and her diploma. Had one young man that graduated with an associate degree as an EMT, graduated on Monday, went to work on Tuesday. So this gives parents and students some options that they don't necessarily have in the regular high schools. Now, I mean, it's different from the standpoint of workforce and that type of thing, but 99% of our kids go on to college. We have 40 that went on to what we call the 13th year.
Now, they get many of them are in line for pretty good scholarships.
We had over $2 million in scholarships for our graduating class last year. Now, public high schools that are a lot larger get a lot of that, but our group with about 110 seniors had a little over $2 million, yeah. And so in the state of South Carolina helps them a lot with the Palmetto fellas and so forth, but they get a lot of scholarships for local colleges and some Ivy League colleges.
Doctor, you've spent your life working with and caring for young people and wanting them to achieve the best they can. That's your gift.
It is.
Really.
Well, I mean, that's what I feel called to.
And I would like to ask you, what do you see from just your own personal point of view as some of the major problems that we face today
in education? Well, you have to go back to the home, okay?
Okay.
You have to go back to the home because the family definition today is not the same definition of the family 10 or 15 years ago. And we as educators have to understand that. We have to embrace that and understand that we have to take the child coming from their family, whatever that is. You know, it's not like Leave It to Beaver and the Cleavers used to be. A family today.
Well, you have the mother and the father, in the home.
And now you know, that's a total mixture. And so we have to take that child and make sure that while we have them, that we prepare them for the 21st century, to prepare them to be lifelong learners, but also prepare them to be productive citizens. And that's something that's different between our country and other countries. People talk about China, people talk about other countries, but the culture in those countries, the focus on education is a whole lot different than it is here. Our children have a whole lot, well, let me just say they have more distractions than they do in a lot of those other countries, okay?
You said it, yes.
And they have more choices. See, everybody has a choice. You have a choice to succeed or you have a choice to fail, okay? Failure is always a choice, and success is a choice. And what we try to make our students understand is that you take it one day at a time, and that, you know, it takes hard work. You know, everybody wants to be a football player. Everybody wants to be an athlete, but only 1% of the kids that graduate from high school in sports go on and make a life out of that.
Yeah.
Now, that certainly helps them get an education and that type of thing with scholarships and stuff, but we're trying to prepare them for life after high school, life after college, or life for work, you know, because the workforce, when you used to get a college degree, you were set for life. Mm-hmm. I heard a parent tell us they had a daughter that went to Yale. 4 years later, they had to, you know, that education they got, spent a lot of money for, because of technology and the way of the world today, you're always going to be going to school. I don't care how old you are, because our society, technology, everything changes. You can't take your diploma of 10 years ago and go out in the workforce and think you're going to continue to keep your job, because you have to continually prepare every day in any job that you're in. Now, that's a little depressing to some kids in high school to think that we're always going to be in school, but you really are always going to be in school because you're going to have to learn because the world's changing. And these students have more access to technology. And I mean, you can talk to your phone and it'll give you a definition. You can give it a word problem, it'll answer it. You know, and maybe if I'd have had that in geometry, I'd have gotten a better grade, but you know, I didn't have that. So I mean, it's just different. And that's why it's so important. And our parents understand that we have got to work together with them.
And,
as a team.
A team effort.
Yeah, and you know, you don't win the Super Bowl every year. But you don't ever try not trying to win the Super Bowl, you know.
Okay, I love that.
You just have to do your best every day, and that's hard sometimes. It's easy to get discouraged. It's easy to get distracted. And so we try to, relationships to me are very important in school, and I mean positive relationships. And that's one of the things that we try to do with the rights, respect, and responsibility. We don't negotiate those.
Now, if somebody out there thinks this is what I'd give to have my child enrolled, what steps do they need to take?
Well, every charter school right now, this is open enrollment, which means you can go on the website, you can fill out the information, and then our lottery is on the 7th, and I think the other schools
They're
are too. Yeah,
different.
Yeah. Well, it's about the same because it's going through the same process, and then. Once they get in, then we interview them to make sure this is where they want to be. That's really important.
That they're
getting
going to
in,
produce.
Because they got to work if they come.
Yeah. So, if anybody out there is interested in learning more or whatever, and I'll keep the information here, but there is a website and there is a phone number, and we as citizens of the United States and of South Carolina need to support our children regardless of what school they're in. And if you have, I say it over and over again, if you have little children at home, read to them. Pick them up. Point out the pictures in the book. Read. And let them know how important it is, because that's going to pay a big, big dividend later on. Am I right?
The technology is great, but you still have to be able to read.
Yeah. And this little book, I'm going to hold it up. First period starts at home. And it's just a little paperback. But it's been endorsed not only by the Honorable Richard Riley, but by Harvard professors, and it was written by my guest. And I think it's just good common sense for parents. So.
Well, one of the things I've found over the years that common sense sometimes is not so common.
That's right. God bless you with the work you're doing. Thank you for coming.
Oh, I appreciate it.
Wherever you are, just keep those books open with your kids. We'll see you next time.